Hey there! Thanks for watching with Wendy. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make a holiday party dress. This dress is a little bit more challenging than some of my other projects just because you need to make a fitted bodice. If you want more details on how that bodice is made, as well as what kind of fabrics to use or how much fabric you need, as always, there's a link below with a lot more details. If it turns out that you like this tutorial, please feel free to subscribe so you can see more. And if you want to reach out to me, feel free to find me on any social media under @withwendy. Finally, I want to wish everyone a very, very happy holidays. If you guys are celebrating Christmas, I hope you can remember the reason for the season, which is that God gave us the greatest gift that we could possibly receive, which is forgiveness through His Son. Because of everything that Jesus did, we're able to be considered free, righteous, redeemed, once again before God. And that's honestly everything I'm living for, which is why I have no problem talking about it with you guys. So wherever you are and whatever holiday you're celebrating, I hope you guys can stay open to this amazing and true gift of love, grace, and peace that God is offering to all of us. Hope you guys really enjoyed this tutorial. I wanted to get it done fast so you could actually enjoy it for the holidays. I want to thank you all so much for watching and for being so supportive and so enthusiastic all the time. Thank you. 2014 has even more tutorials planned, so I hope you guys can look forward to that with me, and I will see you all next time. Bye! Start by folding your fabric in half and cutting out the front side of the bodice piece. If you want more details on how to do this, check out the link that's in the description bar. Next, lay that front piece down onto the fabric and cut out the back piece, but leave plenty of room along the sides, the shoulders, and the armhole. Follow the instructions on the front bodice piece to sew in 4 darts, 2 that are in the front and 1 on each shoulder. Make sure you're sewing in these darts with the right sides of the fabric touching so that when you're done, they'll look like this. Along that top shoulder edge, if there's any unevenness with the fabric, cut off the excess. Lay down that front piece onto the back pieces that you left unfinished and trace out the new shoulder and armholes. I left a little bit of excess fabric along the sides just in case I needed to adjust the fit. Both of the back pieces also need darts along the bottom at the same spot that they're at on the front piece, so make sure you add those in. Now attach that front piece to the back pieces along the shoulders with the right sides touching. Then pin and sew the sides together so that it's the right fit for you. For the skirt of the dress, you're going to need 2 large rectangles and we're going to be pleating the top edge. Start at the middle of that fabric and move outwards with the pins so that every single layer is pinned down. Then sew over the area where you had the pins so that everything gets held in place. In order to make the zipper work, we're going to have to cut the back piece in half first. Then, same as before, pleat those across the top and sew it down in a symmetrical way. With the right sides together, bring those back pieces to the front pieces of the skirt and sew them together along an edge that makes the pleats virtually blend right in. Lay down that top piece with the right sides touching the skirt and sew everything together along the waist area. Whenever you're sewing over a dart, try to make the darts point away from the center of the body. Make sure the collar is nice and round by cutting off any excess. This is also your opportunity to make the neck hole a little bit deeper or the armholes a bit bigger. Pin an invisible zipper to the back side of the dress and see if you have the right fit by putting it on and zipping it all the way up. The trick with getting an invisible zipper right is just to sew as close to the teeth as possible. With your leftover fabric, cut out some strips that are about 2 centimeters wide and are diagonal along the grain of the fabric. Fold one of those edges and pin it to the armpit of the dress, right sides together. Then you're going to sew all the way around, making sure that at the end you cross over a little bit of where you started. This little piece of fabric is known as the bias tape, and what we're going to do is fold it inwards twice and sew that down along those armholes and the collar to finish off the edges. At the zipper, tuck away the raw end first before you fold that bias tape down twice. To finish, you just need to sew up the back of the skirt that's below the zipper and hem the bottom edge of the skirt. Feel free to watch more of my tutorials. Thanks for watching. Bye!